All right.
So what's going on, guys? Just thought I'd do. I had a question on the group here as to what the hairspray method of weathering was. Now this is just a hood. I think it's from 34 Ford. Lindbergh kit that I just built rusted royalty out of. So I'm going to show you on this. Now what I've done is I've already painted, I've used craft paint, burnt umber, this apple barrel stuff. I use it quite a bit. Now I have just brushed it on here with a brush just because I want it to have that rough kind of look to it. If you have like one of the, oxide primers, oxide color primers, you know, it's like a reddish color. That'll work good. It'll work well too. I just didn't have one right now. I used the last of it, so I thought I'd try this. And now it looks shiny because I have put a coat of a gloss coat over this. I know you're thinking gloss for weathering, but after it's done, you want your bib tut was put on there. I just did that to hide to seal that layer in, so that way whenever I start going over this, it won't sink into, it won't show the plastic as much. It won't burn through, I guess you could call it, although it's not really a burn through. But one thing you will need is hairspray. Now this is, it doesn't matter what kind it is, this is just what I have on hand. It's what the little lady uses. And I've got just an empty, this is like a fruit snack cup thing, just empty. And I'm going to go a little farther into this as far as actually putting washes and stuff on. This wash I like a lot. This is it's supposed to be a black. I mean, it says that somewhere on here. Pretty sure. Thought it did. Maybe it doesn't. It's supposed to be a black, but it's more like a dark brown looking color when it goes on. But I like it a lot and I use it a lot. Testers create FX. It's an acrylic. And then I have this one here that I've made. This is just a rust color. This is just that burnt umber. It's just that burnt umber that I showed you before, and alcohol, but it's more alcohol than that. What I do is I'll fill the jar or whatever I'm putting it in full of alcohol, and then I'll just add a few drops of the paint, the color I want it to be, and then I'll take a scrap part and I'll try it and see if it's dark as I want it. If it's not, I'll add some more paint, mix it up good, try it again until I get the results that I'm after, and that's what I use most of the time. I guess I could have showed it to you that way. You might be able to see it a little better. And then also I use dull coat. It's Tester's dull coat. You can see I got it from Hobby Lobby, and you can still see the price on it. But this stuff you can get just about anywhere. They carry Tester's line of paint. I'm about out, but I think I got enough to do this. I'll have to pick some more up. All right, so let's get started. And then you'll need some kind of a brush. There it is. This is the one I'm going to be using. It's just a regular old artist type brush thing, but it's got a soft, bristles on it. So now you can just spray this hairspray right on here. Now, I don't see anything wrong with that. I just like to brush it on. Because then I know I've got good coverage on the part. Son of a. So what I'll do is I'll just spray some in this cup. To be slow and professional with it, as long as you get it on there. however you do, however you can, basically. And if I get a lot on there, I'll try to brush it off the excess as much as I can. You can take like just a paper towel and wipe your brush off. And you don't need a whole lot, it just needs a good even coat basically. Like I say, you can spray it on. Some people prefer to spray it on. Just the way I prefer to do it, it's I think that's good for now. I've got a good coat on, good coverage. We'll let this dry. Maybe I'll get around the edges here just to make sure. Alright. So let that dry, and then I'll come back later and show you the next steps. All right, now our hairspray is dry, so we're ready to put some color over top of this. And I'm going to be using an acrylic, because you want to use an acrylic for this, because I haven't tried anything else, but I'm not sure it would come off basically whenever you add the water and start chipping it off or brushing it off or whatever you want to call it. So we're going to use this cobalt hue. It's like a cobalt blue, but I guess because of trademark, they can't actually call it cobalt blue, so they call it cobalt hue. And I do have some mix, and I mix this stuff 50-50 with washer fluid, just regular old washer fluid like you put in your car. And that's what I have here. So this is what we're going to use. Gonna load up the airbrush here. I don't need too much. And we'll make sure we're spraying all right. A little more pressure. I do like my paint. I found that I like my paint a little thinner than most people, and I like to shoot at a little less air pressure than most people. Like right now, I'm only shooting at about 20 psi, where most people shoot at like 30, 35. And sometimes I'll even drop down to like, I've been playing with the Createx Wicked Colors. And I will actually turn down my pressure down to like 10 or 15 for that, just because I like my, it's pretty thin paint and I like it a little thin anyway. So, but that's a different story. All right, so we'll just go ahead. And I'm just spraying this on my bench because it is craft acrylic paint, and I'm not real concerned with it making a big mess or anything, because it wipes right off. All right. Now, I wouldn't normally put this much on in one coat, but because I'm just just doing a little tutorial here. I will put on that much in one coat. We'll let that dry, and I may even put another couple of coats on there just to make sure I've got good coverage on it. But we'll let that dry, and then I'll be back to show you the next step. All right, so now as you can see, it's all dry. All right, I got going on my tape there, it doesn't want to hold it, but it's all dry now. What we have here is just a cup of water. This is like a lukewarm water. It's not hot, it's not cold. You can take your brush. Now this will work better if you use a stiff brush, but I really don't have what I would call a stiff brush that I use, so I just use something like this. I'm still looking for a stiff brush, but I don't have one that I know of anyway. Basically just dip it in the water, then let it sit there for a minute, it'll work better. What I'm doing is just where the latches are, I'm just going to hit that first, and like where the handle is, just because I know those are places that are highly handled, I should say, like touched a lot, so those are probably going to be your rusty or there's a... You can just keep rubbing and it'll start coming off. Dip it in the water. Should be coming off. I'm gonna have to go find a stiff brush, I think. We'll use this to put some water down though. We'll come back in a few minutes with this tip brush and eat through it. What I'm doing is I'm just covering the whole thing in water, and I gotta go get a stiff brush. Let it soak in for a minute here. Alright. Give me 1 second. I'll be right back. Alright. So we got us a stiff brush now. It's kind of like an artist, like a watercolor brush or something. Now you can see I've already been going at it here a little bit, but basically you just want to take this stiff brush and just brush where you want the paint to come off at. Now this, it may take a little while to get the look you're after, but like I say, just take your time. Be creative. And you can really cover it in water and take your brush again. The edges here is going to be a good place. I know these hoods usually have a hinge in here where they bend quite a bit, so you could weather that up pretty good. I'm trying to get these vents pretty good. I know they rust a lot. They show a lot of rust anyway. You always want to have a paper towel or something handy too, because a lot of times your paint will cover up what you're actually doing, just because it is still on there with water. So what you can do is just take your paper towel and dab it off. And that's what you come up with on that side. I'll do some along the side here, and then I'll finish up the other side off camera. I'm gonna hit this center. Let's get it good and wet first. Just experiment with it. I mean, you can try different things, whatever you can find that works for you. I always say it's the best thing to do. I mean, I could tell you how I do it till I'm blue in the face, but if it's not working out for you and doesn't look the way you want it, then you know, it's no good. There you go. Now I'll go ahead and finish up this other side off camera, and then I'll come back to show you some other little things. Some other little things you can do and try. Alright. Now that we've got that done, that thing is just not going to stay on there, is it? Oh well, it'll be okay. Now that we have that part of the weathering process done, looking decent, I suppose, we're going to start adding some washes. Now, the first one we're going to use is this one I showed you in the beginning. Oh, excuse me. Create FX from Testers. It's an acrylic wash. It's supposed to be the black, but it's more like a, it's kind of like a brown. And I use this stuff. I use this stuff on engines, whatever. And it works great, but it's like I say, it's not the true black, but it works great for what we do with it anyway. Just brush it on. Don't worry about getting it on too thick. I've got a secret that I'm going to show you. Just make sure you get the part covered good. Then I've got this makeup brush. Now, I bought this at the dollar store. You don't have to go out and spend a lot on one. All you need is just something to kind of flip over, and it takes a lot of that off evenly, but it'll leave some too. And it just makes it look that much older, I think, anyway. Now, it's not really dry yet, and you won't be able to tell a lot about it till it is dry, but it is there. Show you again. Basically, just want to get the whole part covered. That you want to do, and you can do it in sections or however you want to do it. And if you want it to show up darker, you can even let it dry on there a little longer before you rub it out, which I may show you on this side maybe. Thank you. happy with that. And then maybe this side I'll show you. You can let it dry on there a little bit longer, and it'll show up darker. Give that a couple minutes to dry. And then also the less you rub it, the more you're going to leave on there, and then the darker it will dry as well. I mean, if you left it like this, it'll dry. You'll still be able to see the blue coming through. And the rust will be a darker color, but it won't be, you know, as bright and vibrant. It's a little bit darker. And you can keep rubbing it. The more you rub it, the lighter it'll get. The less, the more you're taking off, basically. But so that's that. Now I need to let that dry, and then we'll come in and I'll show you some other things that I do. All right, so now that that's all dried good, we'll take our other wash, our rust wash, the one that's alcohol and burnt umber mixed together. Give it a good shake. And this is like a fresh, kind of a fresh rust look, or like, I don't know, or like a streaking look, or whatever you want to say it. And like I say, I just take a smaller little brush. We'll just go right down the center with it here. And you can add little rust spots wherever you want. Like, I'll add some around the edges here. Maybe a few down just everywhere around on it. Yeah. You know, like around where your latches and stuff are, you can put some there. Like I say, just get creative, have fun with it. Right around the bottom, because I know that's going to be really rusty. Do the handle. Come up and hit the, I don't want to do a whole lot on it, but kind of like where the Ford emblem is on the side of here, put some on that. Maybe a couple of these. Couple of these fans here. Around the edge, just put, yeah, go like same thing over here. We can go back through here. Now, you know, I kind of up on the top here where I put those little spots, and I don't really like it down the center, stuff like that, where it looks a little bright for the age of this piece. Can take your black wash back out. You don't need much, because I'm not trying to cover it up. I'm just trying to age it. Brush it over it real quick. And you can take your little makeup brush again and just go over it really fast. And it should darken it up. In the next few steps, I'll be showing you a couple other things to try to kind of blend that in too, so it's not so standout-ish. But I'm going to go ahead and pause the video and I'll get set up to do that. Now, y'all remember this kit, a little thing here from a couple of videos ago. I've got all different kinds of things labeled in here. I got this on it. I don't know what to call it. I don't really remember what I used it for. But I did that color special for something. I don't know. I don't remember what it was for. We've got dark rust, we've got medium rust, and we've got light rust. And then got our little brush here. So we'll start with the dark rust first. We don't use a lot of it because it's just because it's so dark and we've already got a good dark base going. We just need to lighten it up. And you can take your makeup brush again, just brush it down, and it starts. But I think that's enough for the dark. Make sure you get your brush cleaned out good. Can go in with the medium, add a little bit of that. And you can take your brush again, And it's just building up those rust colors, basically, is all you're doing. Then your light rust. Depending on how old you want your rust to look, you can use less or more of this. Now a lot of this, because I am going to seal all this in with a dull coat. Now a lot of this is going to just disappear, like the dull coat will knock the color out of it. So just keep that in mind as you're adding stuff. If it looks a little bright, remember when you put on that dull coat, it's going to knock a lot of that color out. Alright, so I'll hold it out here and give you a look at it. You can use your finger to wipe it, whatever you need to do to make it look the way you want it to look. Like I would come in with an actual black wash and go in between these slats here, just so that was, kind of like, I don't know what happened, but my video cut off on me, so I guess I'll have to upload this in two parts. But that's where we are so far. Now the next step that I'm going to do, I haven't done anything different from when the video cut out except rub over it with my finger. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to have to put me another piece of tape on there and stick it back on the bottle here. Then I'm just going to spray it with a coat of this dull coat and see how it looks after that. Should look pretty good, I hope, anyway. But yeah, we'll do that and we'll be right back. Alright, so there you go. It's all dry now. And it, for whatever reason, seems I do this a lot when I use a blue, it seems to hide it. But this one turned out pretty good. You can still tell that it was blue. And you can see all the rust in it and stuff like that. Pretty much weathered. Now this turned out a little different than I wanted it to turn out, but you can get the idea. Like I say, just get creative, play with it. Just try it. I mean, it's supposed to look old and beaten up and rusted. So anything that you do to it, as long as you end up with that finish, it's right. As far as I'm concerned anyway. And I do this a lot on rat rods, and as y'all know, rat rods, they tend to look a little wacky, a little kooky sometimes. So, if it doesn't work out right, hey, who cares? It's supposed to look that way. It's a rat rod, right? But yeah, hopefully this helps some of y'all out, and I think that's it for now. I'm going to get these uploaded, and maybe I'll take some stills of this so you can see just what it does look like, because I don't know if the camera's really picking it up or not. But I'll get some stills, and I'll talk to you guys later.